Good afternoon, guys. My name is Kenny, and you're watching Brave of the Wilds on YouTube. So today we're going to be doing something a little off track of what we normally do, but it still follows along pretty similar. I don't normally do much on pistols or firearms. This is a 45 airsoft pistol, so it's not a real one, but it is empty and it has no magazine, obviously. But I'm going to go ahead and make a holster for this today, which is something I do quite often on my channel, is make homemade gear for my items and things like that. This belongs to a buddy of mine who wanted a sheath or a holster made for it, and I offered to make him one out of PVC. So I figured I'd show you guys that today. It's going to be a pretty simple project. I do now have a heat gun, so it's going to be a lot easier to make this holster for it. And it should be pretty cool. I've made a couple of these before for another friend of mine, so we'll see how well this one turns out. Hopefully this will be my best one yet, and hopefully he'll like it a lot. So I'm going to go ahead and get out the tools that I need for this, and then we'll go ahead and get started. But pretty much the only thing you're going to need is some 4-inch drain pipe PVC and a heat gun. So stay with me and we'll get started. Okay, so we went ahead and got about a 5-inch section of PVC cut. I already had this left over from our earlier project, so I decided to use it. Basically, we just need to split it down the middle so that way we can take a heat gun and flatten it out solid flat. So basically what I'm going to use is just the cheap Northern Tool Harbor Freight oscillating, I'm not quite sure if you'd call it a saw or what, but basically it's an oscillating type of tool that has very small, almost like hacksaw teeth on it, and that way it'll go down this PVC without having to cut or spin. So it's an interesting way to do it, and it seems to work the best. Alright. As you can see, it cuts right through there really nice, and that's the best tool to use when you have long sections of PVC, like a foot or two, to have to cut. It makes it really easy to do that. And the reason it split open was like that is because the way I had it in the press, it kind of crimped it, so basically wanted to split open, which is good because other times when you put it in there, it tends to bind up and it tends to get stuck on your blade, but this way it tends to open it wide open for you. So that's pretty much it, and then we'll go ahead and move on. We'll flatten it out.
Got our heat gun now, and I just cut out another section of that PVC for the belt loop. So hopefully we'll have enough to actually wrap around the gun and then have a belt loop. I guess we'll see here, but go ahead and get the heat gun cranking. It's got two settings. We're on the hottest, and it's going to take a little bit to get warmed up. You can already see it's kind of turning red in there, so we'll go ahead and start going across the PVC. This stuff's nice and thin, which makes it very, very easy to heat up and bend compared to the thicker PVC. Okay, as you can see, that's pretty flat. It's not, you know, perfectly straight flat, but that's okay because we're just about to heat it right back up when we go to bend it around our pistol. And this is going to be not a full-length pistol sheath or holster. It's going to stop a little bit before, so that way it'll pretty much provide a huge drainage. That way there's no chance of water getting in here and rusting the gun. And the good thing is, now that we have this heat gun, we can heat up fine points of this holster and adjust it exactly the way we want it. We don't have to do massive heats like we used to have to do over the grill. So it's going to make this process a whole lot easier. And what I'm mainly focusing on is getting a nice contour or fold right here so we have a flat spot to rivet. And I'm really pushing in on the trigger, because that's what gives us our retention, is that trigger guard basically provides that little pocket that we can press the plastic into, and that'll make a good locking feature when we go to holster the pistol. As you can see, it's got a nice pop when we do that. That pops what we're going for, and hopefully, well, I know when we rivet this, it's going to solidify that and make that really nice. So the good thing is we can actually go ahead and rivet this and get it shaped, and then we can still do heating up of specific areas to fine adjust it the exact way we want it. So I'm going to keep doing a little bit of specific heats to get this the way I want it, and then we'll start working on the belt loop. Alright everybody, so I'd have to say I really, really like this heat gun compared to the grill, because I can do so much more pinpoint control of where I'm heating up. As you can see right here, it's heavily contoured, and that's what's going to give us our good retention in there. And so with that heat gun, I was able to really pinpoint that and get it nice and hot and mold it very nicely. So the next thing I'm doing is I went ahead and made a spot right here, because the mag release, if you look, is right there, and we don't want that hitting there and accidentally losing your mag when you're running around. So we're going to go and make a little indention so that way it never actually gets covered, and we don't get the chance of accidentally losing our magazine. So we're going to get that taken care of, and then we're going to go ahead and get on the bandsaw and cut this line, make sure we have enough room for some rivets around here, and then pretty soon we'll be going ahead and folding over and making our belt loop and attaching that right here. I'm not quite sure exactly how I'm going to do that quite yet. I'm thinking of doing something a little bit different that's going to make it sit a little bit higher up on the belt, which is, I think, the way he's going to like it. So once I get that thought out, we'll get going on that, and then we can go ahead and throw the rivets in it, and we should be done. All right, so I went ahead and cut out that rough little bit of excess. I sanded this side to even that up, and then I went ahead and put my three dots for where I'm going to want my rivets. I got this thing fitting very, very nicely. This is definitely going to be my nicest one yet, and I got that little bit of notch cut out right there for the mag release, and then I'm going to go ahead and put a rivet right there, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but there's a little gap, let me find it here, right next to the mag release right there, so that way I can rivet the actual loop onto the back here, and it won't interfere with the gun coming in and out of the sheath, because there's already a gap there. When the gun comes in, you can see the light coming through, so that's where I'll put the rivets so they won't interfere, and we'll have a nice belt loop that'll sit about right here, so that way it'll keep the gun pretty well height-wise on the belt, so it'll be easy to access, but it won't be too low that's flopping around when you're running. So let me go ahead and get these rivets put in, that'll be the next step, and then we'll clean up this last bit a little bit more, and then we'll start working on the belt loop. Alright everybody, so I took a look at the sheath that I made, and I spent some tinkering with it, or I did a little bit of time tinkering with it afterwards, and I really didn't like how it worked because I kind of made a mistake. What the actual retention system should be is this divot right here, and then there should be a corresponding divot on the back that creates basically the retention system. And the way that should work is the way this one does here, and this is a new one that I've made since then. And you'll notice it has a corresponding divot right here to go with this one right here. So if you look, it creates that funnel. Now you should not have a rivet back there because it's supposed to be able to spread apart, as you can see, when it goes through that divot. So that's the way the sheath should work, and I kind of made a mistake when I put one back there because it locked that down and kept that from happening. So it made it so when you put the gun in, it pulled back the rack, or the slide, excuse me. So that was a mistake, and it caused the slide to get a little bit messed up when you put it in the sheath. So this new one, no problem with that, because the retention comes from that right there. And the good thing is you can basically fine tune how tight you want to fit in there by just heating up this one little section, either pushing it in more, as you see the divot right there, by pushing it in more or just letting it come out a little bit. You can really fine tune how well this gun fits in there. So the next thing is going to be the belt loop, and I've had some struggles in the past of making good belt loops, and I think this is going to be the best system so far. What I'm going to do is, I've got the two holes marked where the gun does not actually make contact with the sheath. I'm going to drill those out and then do corresponding holes on this extra piece of PVC right here, and I will attach the two together, and then from there I will bring this piece, heat it up, and bring it back up to the top to create the finished little inside area for your belt to slip in, and that will be the finishing part of our little holster here. I've had some struggles in the past, like I've said, with trying to get this done right, so I'm going to go ahead and do this one again, or do it for the first time and see how well it turns out, and hopefully I won't have to do it again. But the way I see it, it should turn out pretty good. So let's go and get started on that. Alright, well, I apologize guys, I forgot to turn the camera on. I was in the moment getting these two rivets in, but it wasn't that big of a deal. If I could recommend something to you guys, when you do it, try and keep this back part a little bit higher up than this front, so that way you can wedge that pop riveter in there a little bit better than I did. What I had to do was I had to put it in there at an angle, and then I had to take a punch and kind of flatten down the side that was sticking up on the rivet, so that way the gun wouldn't get all marred up going in and out. But as you can see, we're getting there and it's looking really nice. So pretty much the last step is to take some of this and bend it up over the top of here and then rivet it if we want to, and then if not, it'll probably still be just as good. So let me go ahead and get that done and then we'll be finished. Alright, well that looks very, very nice, because now all you have to do is just pull this out, drop your belt through, and then back up, and it'll keep it in there and keep it from falling out, but it's a quick access. Also, if you have thicker belts, it'll kind of expand out to accommodate your belt. And that's pretty much it, guys. Throw some paint on there and you're good to go.
Alright everybody, well I just finished cleaning up the garage and I wanted to give you a last look at the completed finished product. I've actually been wearing it for the past 45 minutes the whole time I spent cleaning up and taking the trash up. I wore it and it's plenty comfortable. It's actually very comfortable. This is actually mainly set up for a pistol belt. I'm carrying on a pistol belt, so it is a bit wide. If you're going to make this for your belt, I would suggest narrowing it so that way it doesn't create such a wide spot on your belt. But it's really easy to take on and off. You just put your belt up under that piece of plastic to get up under like so. And then you slip it over the other one and it's on just like that. And I mean, it's not coming off. And then to take it out, it's nice and easy. Again, I just made it, so I'm getting used to how it works, but I think it's really good. As you can see, it comes out and goes back in very easy, but it won't move around and it certainly won't come out. And it's very nice, quick deploy. So I hope you guys like that. Little gun holster. I think it was a pretty cool project. I think my buddies are really going to like it. And if I ever decide to get one of these in the near future, I'll definitely make a holster for it, because it's a really nice holster. I like it a lot. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the next one.